everybody. Welcome to GOAT Talk. I am your host, Josh. And today, we have two football players about to go pro. My boy, Dario Jones, and my boy, Mike Buchanan. How y'all doing today, fellas?
I'm doing good. What about you?
Sure, I'm cool. You know, with my sandals on, my hoodie up, you know, I'm chilling. What about you, Dario?
Man, I'm blessed, man.
That's good.
Another day, another dollar.
That's good. You know, coming off a real good season, 9-3, you know. How'd you feel coming off this season, personally?
Shit, I felt good coming off this season, you know what I mean? We came in as freshmen 2-8, ended 8-2, 8-3 if you count the bowl game. I mean, and everything as far as stats-wise had a change of events as well.
Yeah, what about you, Mike?
Honestly, for me, leaving the season, it felt good. Just see how much we matured throughout the years. And really bought into the program. And for the young guys, just see how much we played a bigger role on the old guy life, so we bought in.
I know you guys participated in the bowl game. What was the feeling like during that game?
The bowl game, it went either way. I mean, I'm glad we made it, but it was some people that felt like they was already, you know, on Thanksgiving break. Like, yeah. They was like, man, all right, we made it this far, man, let's go home. There were some people that was like, man, let's go out here and win. Even though the conditions was bad as far as the field, I mean.
Yeah, it
was a surreal feeling, though. I mean, it was cold, it was muddy.
Snowy, you know, too.
It was a bad condition, but, I mean, we still went out and had fun, though, to end the season off.
How about you, Mike?
For me, the bowl game, I felt like we could have played better. But I'm happy that we made it there. The conditions varied. They suck, like we said. But I felt like if we would have tuned in, the game would have went a whole another way. We would have came out on top.
I feel you. Dario, I know you just came back from a Senior Bowl game not too long ago. How was that?
Yeah, I had an All-Star game in Myrtle Beach. And it was a good feeling, you know, nice weather, good group of guys. Mm-hmm. I mean, it wasn't as organized as I thought it would have been.
Like, what were the practices like? Like,
short. When we was practicing, I mean, it was basically like a scrimmage. I mean, it's just a bunch of dudes from all over just coming out there just to really showcase their talent. I mean, we had a little, you could say it was a trial, but it wasn't really a trial. It was just like, I mean, if you want to play that, play it. And then we was coming up with plays on the spot. Both offense and defense. I mean, we had three kick returners, so that tells you something right there.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it was definitely fun, though. My team won, you know what I mean, Southside. You know what
I feel you.
But, yeah, it was a good experience, though. I recommend it to whoever get invited if they have the money to invest because, I mean, it definitely was some scouts there. It definitely was some people there. And you get to play. I mean, it was definitely a lot of talent out there, though. So,
yeah. You know. And Mike, I know you got a couple of invites too as well for the bowl games. Like, did you go to any of them or?
I got invited to two. I went to both of them, but I only participated in one. I participated in one in Miami. Mm-hmm. It was very good. There was a lot of competition out there. Not just on my level, but upper level. So I had to step my game up.
Yeah.
We did a lot of one-on-ones. It was like a position battle out there that you had to just really. You had to really win. Unfortunately, I was second screen, but I played more than the first screen did. He got hurt, so I had to step up. In the second game, down in Mobile, Alabama, I just went down there after a couple questions. Both games had a lot of scouts.
I feel you. This is a personal question for you guys. What made you guys want to start playing football when you guys were little?
What made me start playing football, gotta be Mike Vick. I just seen him doing some spectacular things out there.
Oh, so that's your inspiration.
You know, I play defense, you know. But as I grew older and matured, Tyron Matthew and Jamal Adams, they just play different. So I just want to model their game and see how far I can go, and just learn more and more because football took me all over the world so far.
I feel you.
Cap. I ain't gonna lie, my favorite player is Michael Vick. So I don't know where that came from. But I mean, I wouldn't say Vick inspired me to play,
mm-hmm.
but he definitely was one of the like inspirations of me playing, like when I was playing.
Right.
Like as far as staying in it and like my style of play type thing, you feel me?
Yeah.
I played both offense, defense, and special teams. So I mean, I wore the number 7 before I had the Vic cleats. But I mean, I don't know. I just like football though. I mean, my first sport was basketball.
Right.
I wanted to do football. So I did football probably like my 7th grade year. And then from there, I mean, I was good at it. So I just kept at it for real.
Yeah,
in college, so you know.
Yeah, cause I know them Vicks cleats, they were pretty nice.
They was.
All black.
They were tough, man. Straight from the A, you know. But
yeah.
Yeah, that way.
I feel you on that. But have you guys been doing any personal training since the season's been over?
Of course.
Like, what's the process? Like, how you guys been doing in that? Like, what's the routine, the daily routine?
Well, I mean, now it's just working out for real. I mean, it's too cold to really be outside doing drills.
Right.
I mean, we did it before the break. So, I mean, it ain't like we can't do it. But, I mean, you just got to be smart. It's snowing. The conditions was bad then, so it's like it gotta be worse now. If you go to Sky Field or the game field, it's still right. Gonna be the same. But I mean, I do track now too, so that's another way I work on like my speed, my agility, and like getting flexible. I mean, I'm ready to start going back to doing yoga. Mm-hmm. So you know what I mean? All that correlates, all that go hand in hand.
True. What about you, Mike?
For me, I work out Monday through Saturday. Sundays be recovery days.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of foam roller with the bands. Throughout the week, I work on a lot of explosive. I do more lower body than upper body, but the things I'm working on now, you know, 40 time down, vertical increase, broad jumps. I'm just working on those things every day, and in between classes, I'm stretching.
Mm.
I'm doing some type of physical activity.
Dang, I know your leg is hurting, bro. Yeah. I know they hurting. Shoot. But how does it feel being a prospect, though?
Mm.
Like, the tension and everything, all that.
That's a good question. I mean, for me, it's really no difference. Because I always knew I was going to be one of those guys. Because I got a lot of connect, so I knew what was going on the whole time. But at first, I had, like, the big head. But I just humbled down and just try to learn as much as I can. Learn throughout this process,
mm-hmm.
no matter who I may be around.
And Mike, I saw your social media. I was on Instagram and I saw the pictures of you, like giving back to the community, to the little kids. Like, what made you want to do that? Like, cause that was a beautiful thing. Like, what made you want to do that? I want to learn.
That's something I always wanted to do for years, but last summer it just really just motivated me when I was working with the kids from the Boys and Girl Clubs.
Mm-hmm.
I just wanted to go back to my elementary school and just be a help to those kids, be a blessing, no matter what it may be, just supply them with the things they may need, because I was in their shoes once upon a time, and I needed school supplies also.
I feel you. And Dario, I know you've been doing things back in your community in Baltimore. Like, tell us the process about that with the COS and everything.
Well, I mean, with COS, that ain't really too much for football. I mean, I've been doing a thing in Baltimore called Four Leaf.
Yeah.
It's a thing me and Noodles, Malcolm, he play overseas football right now. Me and him been doing it for real. We get the kids around the neighborhood, sign a little waiver, and man, they come out, we train them, do drills, then we do like a 5-on-5 or 7-on-7, depending on how many kids come out. We do like a little scrimmage game, you feel me? We also did like 40 times and shuttle and things that end up having to do, like, when, cause it be young kids, like some of them don't even be in high school, some of them do be in high school, so we be just training them to get like where we at for real. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And it's keeping them out the street, so it's basically doing something they love without being around the wrong crowd, in the wrong places, you know what I mean?
That's
so
good.
Yeah.
Man, that's good. Well, the process of getting back to the community, yeah, that's a blessing, though. You know, there's some kids, they running around here, they ain't got nothing else to do, you know.
Yeah, that's when you find trouble.
I know.
But when they find you.
Football saved a whole lot of lives, too, for real.
For sure.
I'm a rap cap.
Yeah, for real. Okay, so who do y'all think gonna win the Super Bowl, though?
Chiefs.
Chiefs?
Yeah, I got the Chiefs all the way.
I got the Chiefs winning.
Why y'all say that Tyrann Mathieu?
He with Tyrann Mathieu. I'm with Patrick Mahomes.
So no Tyree Hill?
I mean, I like Tyree Hill. I like Kelce. I mean, they got a lot of weapons.
True.
So, I mean, that speaks for itself right there. Mm-hmm. I mean, so do 49ers, too. But, yeah, I definitely think Chiefs are taking it.
Championships right here.
Like,
that's all I'm saying.
I mean, they say offense sell tickets, but that's how you get the points on the board to even, you feel me?
True.
Get the lead.
I mean, defense put points on the board, too.
Facts.
Yeah, especially when you got a guy like Tyrann Mathieu.
Yeah, but they got a good 49, got a good D, too, so, I mean, you can't dwell on a D too hard without having that O.
49 sure. Really ain't got an offense like that.
Exactly. You can't. The Chiefs got the O.
I feel you. I'm with the Chiefs, man. You know, Tyreek, Patrick Mahomes, Sammy Watkins. Oh, you think? For real, though. All right, so outside of football, though, what do you guys like to do?
I mean, outside, like, I've been reading a lot lately.
All right, what's the book you've been reading so far?
The Magic of Thinking Big, and I've been reading a lot about the Bible. Well, I've been reading the Bible also, but the magic about the big, it just shaping your mindset, thinking about, it's showing you got two different mindsets, the positive mindset and the negative mindset. The more you feed the positive, the negative go away. If you feed the negative, the positive go away.
Right.
So it's just all about shaping your mindset, becoming a better version of yourself, and watching the ones that you ain't surround yourself around, and try to make them become better also.
What about you?
Man, I do everything, man. I be balling. I got clothing line. I be trying to keep up with, and I be rapping. I be looking. I don't really read books, but I read stuff online. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Podcasts, interviews. Cause those are also tools to learn stuff and, you know, enhance yourself as well, but I can't really get into books though. You know what I'm saying?
I mean, you gotta find a good book.
Yeah, that's cool. Mm-hmm.
Another thing the book taught me though, you feel me? It ain't about the book taught me it ain't about what you know, it's about who you know.
True.
And it's about being productive, not always knowing the actual facts. Just because you know something don't mean you know how to do it.
True.
So if you're productive, you don't get a job. But just because you know something don't mean you don't get a job.
True.
But in this world you gotta be productive and learn how to just work towards things.
And I learned that without reading. So I mean, it's whatever tools you got, you
true.
Use them.
Right. Get it from somebody, you know. But I know on social media you had two albums that are out right now, or two mixtapes.
I got one. I mean, my little cousin, dropped one for him. Because, like I said, I do a lot. So, COS, we branching out, you know what I'm saying? We got a production company. So, we do the music, we do the clothes, we be trying to branch to the films now. We're trying to do everything. See which one takes us all the way for it.
So we can find this on Spotify, Apple Music.
All streaming platforms.
All right. And how long has it been out? It's been out for a long time, hasn't
it?
Nope.
Second one just came out over the break, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Just right there. And then mine's came out a few months ago.
All right, cool. What is your favorite memory during your football career? Like, either from the ground, like Little League all the way up to college?
Mine had to be my senior night in high school. Hit a dude with a boom boom. Lowered my shoulder, first touchdown ever. That's in high school, but here, gotta be my first pick in Minnesota, -5 degrees.
Yeah, I heard it was cold over there.
All right, look.
He was there.
It was cold.
It was cold. All right, well, if we gonna do both, I'm gonna say for Little League, I had a lot in Little League. I mean, I had a game where I scored 4 times.
Mm-hmm.
And then high school, I ran a kickback. My first time switching from offense to defense, they tried to really get me to play strictly D. I was not having it. So, man, my coach bumped heads. So as soon as I switched to offense, I scored twice against a so-called rival. You know what I'm saying? But other than that, college, it would have had to been this year. I mean, I had you know, stuff all throughout like my 4 years, but
yeah,
this year,
the back-to-back
picks,
yeah,
was definitely a highlight.
I mean, my favorite memory of him gotta be against Northwest at pick six.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah.
I like that. You did.
And then it was two picks back-to-back games, so that's four in two games.
True.
Yeah, that was definitely a highlight, bro. Cause I mean, I didn't expect it.
I did.
I just was out there playing.
True.
And I'm a guy that don't like defense. I like to tell Mike during the games.
Every game, you get him.
I'm already on. So, if you guys had to do a 40-yard dash race, who do you think would win?
I already know Derrick will win. I ain't gonna cap to you.
So you're selling yourself short.
It ain't no cap my rap though. You feel me?
But I don't even race.
I'm that 4-5.
But you do track though, don't you?
I'm talking like street racing. Like, oh yeah, yo, let's see who faster. I don't really do all that.
So you never got into that when you was a kid?
I have, but I don't be liking it. Like, I mean, you know, some people be doing it for the money. Like, you know what I'm saying? I'll definitely do it and take the bread, but I ain't the one that's gonna say it. It's people that want to race me, cause they know I'm fast. I know I'm fast. I want to get fast. I do other competitive things for that. Like, you know,
I mean,
racing was never.
I mean, they say in order to get fast, you gotta race the fastest person.
Well, let me race Usain Bolt then.
You're gonna have to lose a couple times for that. You know,
I do it like Kevin Hart did it, right. Yeah. And they did it on a basketball court, and they had dribble the basketball. Up, back, see who could do it the fastest.
Sure.
I'd do that too.
That sounds fun, though.
Yeah, it was a fun event.
I mean, I'm your 4-5 low range jumper guy. 4-5. 4-5-9, 4-6, somewhere in there.
So no 4-3-3?
No, none of that. All my money come in the weight room, though. 225, I'm your guy.
I feel you.
Yeah.
Big weight, you know, already. All right, so any advice for the people that's chasing their dreams right now?
For me, if you're chasing your dream, keep grinding. Don't never stop. Never listen to people when they tell you can't do it, do something, because if you got Christ on your side, you can do anything you want. And be anyone you want to be. Just be yourself through it all. Don't try to change up. Don't sell your soul, because money come and go. But your soul don't.
True.
I'ma just recap on what he just last said. Mike is with the Illuminati.
So he got the black hoodie on and everything, bro, for real.
Bro, he with the Illuminati, bro.
The black pointed hoodie and stuff. He sounds so sinister, dark.
No, but right if now. I was to say anything though, I'd say, man, look, don't be discouraged from any type of adversity that go your way. If you don't try to overcome it, even if it's tough and you be like, you know what I mean, and it's weighing you down, if you don't try to overcome it, bro, then it's not for you.
True.
Because ain't nothing easy, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So it's like, if you don't try, then you never know if you can do it.
True.
And if you just quit, then why do it in the first place?
True.
And I'm going to just keep it like that, short, sweet, to the point.
That is true. Thank you guys for being on my show, though. It's been real.
Sure, J-Rob,
like, all right, anybody, you guys want to say y'all social media or anything, tell them to follow you or anything?
Yeah, you can follow me at 00Dario, that's 00Dario. I'm pretty sure it'll be in the video, so I ain't really spell my name. But yeah, you can follow me on that, I mean.
All I want to say, just be on the lookout for me.
Yeah, me and Mike, man, we ready to go pro, man. You did.
We on the way up, man. No rep count.
For sure.
Trying to stay healthy so we can go, you know what I'm saying? He be trying to mess my body up, you know what I'm saying?
I feel you.
But nah, it's the grind, though, you feel me? The grind don't stop for nobody.
Yes, sir. I already know. All right, guys, this is the first episode of the GOAT Talk, so catch me every single time on Thursdays at 6 o'clock. Tune in.